Hey everyone, welcome to the video. I'm going to be going over my favorite plays at wide receiver for week 14 on DraftKings. So starting off at the high end, we're going to lead off with Antonio Brown as our numero uno for this week. Oakland is number one DVOA versus wide receiver ones, but I don't care. There is no one on the Raiders defense capable of stopping Antonio Brown. And you can say Tyreek Hill was shut down last week by looking at the box score, but he really wasn't. Mahomes and Hill just missed on a couple wide open touchdowns last week, and this doesn't mean much, but just thought it was something fun to share. In Antonio Brown's last game against Oakland a couple years ago, he had 17 receptions on 23 targets for 284 yards. And Pittsburgh also has the second highest implied total at 31, so sign me up for some Antonio Brown this week. Next up is Davante Adams. He has been one of, if not the most consistent wide receiver in fantasy this year. Now we get the juicy matchup versus Atlanta, who is 28th DVOA versus wide receiver ones, and are a bottom half team in points given up at the position. I think this will be a high scoring game, and you'll want a piece of Rodgers' guy. You should see a lot of Robert Alford, who is PFF's 6th worst corner on the year. In the same game, on the opposite side, I love Julio coming off a down game, where he only had 18 yards on 2 catches. He's under 8K this week in a great matchup in what I think will be a back and forth game. The Packers are 22nd DVOA versus wide receiver ones, and are giving up the 9th most points per game to receivers. I think this is a big bounce game for Julio, and if he comes in at a lower ownership because of that game, just better for you guys. I think it's obvious why we like Keenan Allen this week, so I'll keep it short. He doesn't get priced up like he should, so he's actually an incredible value at only 7,400 going against Cincy. And last one in the high end, and again, sorry, there's so many in the high end this week, just so many good matchups, but it's Juju, really for all the same reasons I like Brown. I really don't need to tell you that Oakland sucks. So let's go to the mid-range now. There's really not much I liked from the mid-range or bargain bin this week, but I really like these two guys. Adam Humphries, he's been surprisingly great this second half of the year, and now he gets a matchup versus our favorite guy to pick on, PJ Williams. The good times for Humphries shall continue in this matchup. And on the same team, I also really like Chris Godwin. I read reports that Jackson may not play again, so that would vault Godwin back into play again this week at sub-5K. I also read that Jackson might be out for the rest of the year. I found this info from Adam Leviton's Twitter that Chris Godwin's lines in the games that Jackson has missed so far are 3 for 98, 7 for 111 in a touchdown, and 5 for 101 in a touchdown. So he's averaging over 100 yards per game and almost a touchdown per game when Jackson's out. So I think this is an excellent play against Eli Apple. And just to name a non-buck in the mid-range, I'll leave you with Manny Sanders coming off a bad game versus Cincy. You won't see Sherman much at all, as he's a slot receiver, and he's going to see a lot of Kwan Williams in the slot. So this is a matchup he can win. Now to the bargain bin. This is really ugly this week, guys, so I'm sorry. But I found two guys that aren't absolutely terrible. So we'll start with Bruce Ellington. He's only 3,800, and he should see a lot of Leonard Johnson in the slot, who's one of the worst corners in the league, according to PFF. His A-dot is laughably low, but hey, he can get 5 to 7 catches and somehow fall in the end zone, maybe. There's almost zero upside here, however. And last guy is a min-price guy I found on DraftKings, Chad Williams. So yeah, I said he's min-price, and he's going against Detroit, who's a terrible versus pass. And Darius Slay is not going to waste his time on him, so it could open some things up for him. If you're wondering who the heck this guy is, he'll be stepping in for Christian Kirk, since he underwent season-ending surgery. Alright guys, that's all I have for the wide receivers this week. If you have any questions, let me know, and I'll be doing tight end and defense very shortly.